I really had to see it for myself. A man described as having it all. Super sports cars, the kind featured in young men's fantasies. A dream home with a lovely Christian family. With all that, why would anyone spend time, money, and so much effort to make sure that others know the Jesus who for him has become Savior and Lord of everything? So I've traveled to Prague in the Czech Republic to learn firsthand the story of Radim Pasek. He's a man who's triumphed over personal tragedy, trials, and setbacks to be used by God in the most unusual ways. I'm Bill Knott, and the journalist in me loves a good story. Radim lives just outside Prague. This historic city, often referred to as Beautiful Prague, is one of the word-of-mouth favorites for seasoned travelers and those who love history. I've read about Radim's wealth. It would be hard to ignore the way his name shows up on business and real estate websites that feature development in Europe. I've even read descriptions of his missionary work around the world and his affection for the little town of Stetkovice. He rebuilt key parts of this old farming village, added value to it in ways that enriched the residents' lives. It's a town of less than 300 people, and it's a place where Radim has built a unique relationship with his neighbors.
In the Bible, Jesus says that it's easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter heaven. We're going to see if that's true in this case.
This is my wife, Barbara. We've married in 2012. 1 year later, our Samuel was born. In 2015, another son, Benjamin, was born. And Timothy was born in 2018.
It's very apparent it takes both mother and father to raise three active boys. What's it like to try to raise three sons who are all very active?
Já bych řekla, že kluci jsou sice aktivní, ale není to tak, že by byli nezvladatelní. Takže díky bohu máme tu velkou přednost, že jsou kluci klidní, umí taky zlobit, ale myslím, že můžeme být Pánu Bohu velice vděční za to, jaký mají povahy.
Radim, how do you balance a very busy corporate career with a commitment to three boys under the age of six?
You have to balance, of course, every day with your time. I have three big portions.
Yes.
It's, of course, my business, it's my ministry, it's my family. Sometimes you have also some personal hobbies, but at the end, it's very important to spend your time with your kids, because it's one of the best investments you can do. As a Christian parents, it's very important to raise our kids for Jesus.
It was worship time, and Radim's oldest son, Radim Jr., joined them. Sitting with Radim and reflecting on his little ones, I found myself thinking about how Radim's sons are near-perfect replicas of him when he was their age. Radim Pasek was born in 1963, just 5 years before the remarkable flowering of democracy known as the Prague Spring. a brief moment of hope that was squashed when Czechoslovakia was invaded by the Soviet Union and several Warsaw Pact nations.
You grew up at a time that was very difficult in this country. In fact, in your book, you refer to this era as the building of socialism era. What was it like being a teenager at the time of communist dominance in Czechoslovakia?
Of course, the main issue for most of the people was lack of freedom. My childhood was quite happy, but in my teenage age, I could still more and more be aware about real lack of freedom in our country, and it wasn't encouragement.
By August 1968, Soviet and Warsaw Pact armies invaded Czechoslovakia and restored normalization, postponing your hopes that someday you might really be free as God created you to be.
For a man whose life is very different now, how do you look back at that time?
Of course, the life cost in socialism was substantially lower than today.
Did you ever have any idea that you might someday have a life like this?
That time, for sure not.
In the late 1970s, there weren't many ways up and out toward freedom, but one of them was sports. During his teen years, Radim knew exactly what he wanted to be, a professional soccer player.
Many young boys dream to be the best soccer player in the world. The same was with me.
Antonin Panenka! Oh, it's genius! And Czechoslovakia are European champions!
When I was 11, I started to play for a very good team, Bohemians Prague. I was quite talented and I liked to do nice things with the ball and score the goals.
Radim and I met in the first grade. I would sit behind him and kick his chair. After that, we shared a table together. Radim was an excellent football player. He would always play with people that were 3 or 4 years older than him, and he was really good. For about 15 years, he was very serious about football.
When I was 18 and I started to play the junior league in our country, I get a little bit crazy.
There was a moment where there were girls and parties. Football became second, so that's when he changed.
I started drink alcohol, I started to smoke, and it really didn't help with my soccer career. The next 6 years was quite stupid in my life.
You wrote very candidly in your autobiography about visiting bars and clubs and casual relationships. In fact, one friend advised a young woman, be very careful of Radim, he's a womanizer.
Unfortunately, it was the truth. After my high school degree, I had two options. One, to go for 2 years for the communist army. And the second option was to continue with study in university. So I chose to continue with the study, but I wasn't a good student.
You weren't able to finish that degree. And that by the time you were in your early 20s, you actually found yourself working as a street sweeper.
Yes, it was always to get some money going to the pubs or bars. My parents didn't want to help me with my bad lifestyle. When I was 24, I understood I destroyed my life. I spoke with some of my friends. They recommended me to start something in the gym. So I did. And after 1 year, with some positive progress, I quit smoking. I went back to my team in soccer, but very shortly after, my knee injury came, so I couldn't play on the top level. One Czech-German guy from real estate asked me to work for him in spring of 90. His idea in Czech Republic was just to buy the properties. I helped him to find suitable properties which were potential for buying. I've got some good reputation from the banks, and when I started to do my own business at the end of 91, banks trusted me.
My first impression of him was, wow, this is a new sort of a Czech entrepreneur, and he was trying to be very honest from the beginning in the, let's say, 90s, where here in the Czech Republic we lived in a little bit, let's say, Wild West.
At the beginning, we just bought some properties, and after quite short time, we sold them again.
The impression was really very positive, because he think like the Western people thought. I'm a specialist in real estate finance. In the 90s, we started to finance the first office schemes and shopping centers and industrial properties.
The interest rates at that time in Czech Republic was quite high. It wasn't possible to keep the real estate for a long time.
So Mr. Basser came with a very big model of a house, put the model in the middle of a table, and the people tried to persuade the banks here in Czech Republic to finance the first offices here.
Were beginning to blow in Czechoslovakia, and some of those were the result of the creative work of Václav Havel, one of Eastern Europe's most talented playwrights and authors. Havel's influence accelerated with the rise of Mikhail Gorbachev as first secretary of the Soviet Communist Party, and what Gorbachev had hoped would give legitimacy to the communist system actually brought it to a crashing halt. What began as a trickle of student protesters became a nationwide movement to peacefully overthrow the one-party state under which Czechs and Slovaks had lived for more than 40 years. 500,000 people swelled the streets of Prague to demand the lifting of restrictions on speech, culture, religion, and trade.
Shortly after Velvet Revolution, I met the girl of my dreams, who became my wife in the June 93. I had my marriage.
I knew his wife very well. She lived in my building two floors down.
You were at a point when your business career was taking off. Your company was fairly new and growing rapidly. You had recently gotten married. After 4 years, your wife is expecting your first child. That must have been a moment initially that seemed very, very hopeful to you.
Absolutely. It was meaning of my life to have son and to hand over one day my successful family business to him. I was 35. That was top of my professional and personal life. Even the first building of BB Centrum was successfully finished and leased, but I was much more happier because of our first son. The name Max was quite traditional in our family. My father was Max, my grandfather and my great-grandfather. It was quite a traditional name, so my father was very happy about it.
Early on, things looked quite stable for the little boy you called Little Max.
6 weeks we thought we have healthy baby boy in our home. And after 6 weeks, my wife noticed he's not eating so well as he should. So next day we visited hospital and we've got known he's sick in his brain and he has to go some surgery next day.
At 6 weeks old?
Yes, 6 weeks old. And the surgery happened well, but the doctors needed to know what was the reason for the surgery. So he had to go under magnetic resonance.
Yes.
The result was really big tragedy for us because he had a tumor in his head and he had no chance to survive. It was first time in my life I answered to my wife, I would like to change myself, because she told me God wanted to say us something. And we started to pray.
Hadn't really been praying people before?
Definitely not me. I started to pray, even though I didn't know how. And we believe that little Max will be healed.
Yes.
Because of God's grace. But at the end, it didn't happen. He died when he was 9 weeks old. It was, I would say, the worst part of my life.
Could anything good come out of this tragedy? Would a loving God be able to bring something into Radim's life that could have happened in no other way?
I was aware I am not a person who is living according will of God. I knew it. I wanted the little Max to be raised a better person than I was. But now there was no chance to change it.
Everything was going so well for Radim. I didn't know it was going to work out. The moment this happened with Max, it was really, really hard to accept.
One of the first interests to understand from Bible is what's happened after that.
Right.
What is with little Max? Because I grew up in Catholic family, so there is teaching about immortal soul.
Yes.
And my first idea or my first impression was to going every day to the cemetery and talk to little Max. I've got very soon information from the Bible, thanks to our friends. There is some other solution. There is nothing after that. And it wasn't easy for me to understand.
Radim's ex-wife's uncle happened to be an Adventist, and she asked him to pray for them.
But cousin of my wife, Simona, she was Seventh-day Adventist that time. She spoke with my wife very often about the Bible, and my wife felt that her cousin told her biblical truth. But she knew it was not possible to talk with me about it before sickness of little Max. But then things changed, and I was ready to listen to the voice of God.
In 1998, the global Seventh-day Adventist Church turned its attention to Net 98, an international evangelistic event hosted by Dwight Nelson, the pastor of the Pioneer Memorial Church. Men and women in dozens of countries heard the word of God that brought fresh hope to tens of thousands who were struggling to know what to do with their newfound freedom.
During this time, you also started studying the Bible and other inspired writings to learn more as fast as you could. This was a real growth time in your life, even though it had been a time of loss.
I met Mr. Radim Passera in 1994. Our friendship was strictly business. 4 years later, we met as personal friends at Net 98.
How did you integrate what you were learning from the Bible about the future with your own plans for the future as a businessman?
When I first met Radim, we were at one of the Net 98 meetings. I saw them watching a video, and Radim and his wife showed up with their leather jackets and looked like bikers.
I knew Ms. Passera through his wife's cousin. She went to church every once in a while, and we shared the same faith. But with Radim, I was very shocked.
He was looking for something that could guide him. Something that could give him faith to move forward.
I was shocked. Every day Radim made time to come to the meetings.
So he came to the pastor.
The timing was for us perfect. So I visited with my wife all 27 lectures.
All 27 lectures,
yes.
In a row.
It was great learning for me because it was in the time I started to understand Bible. Of course, prophecies, it is what really makes your faith deeper.
Somehow, the Bible truth about death and resurrection was a great comfort right then, was it?
It was already some encouragement for me because I learned, okay, small babies like little Max couldn't take any decision for or against Christ. One of my questions was, can I personally do something to be with him again? And through Jesus, it is possible.
When couples go through a loss like that, many of them struggle in their relationship. Was that also true for you and your wife?
Not really, because we both had the same desire to live our lives with Jesus. And it united us. We decided after Net 98 to be baptized in the Seventh-day Adventist Church. We were sure we would like to be part of this church.
I've seen a video clip of an unusual baptism by immersion,
yeah,
under the water, both of you at once. That isn't done very often.
Yeah, we spoke with pastor about the possibilities of our baptism, and he suggested us it can be the way how we can be baptized, and we liked it. To understand, you can have in the heaven your small baby, and without any fear, without any pain, you can raise him in the perfect environment of the heaven, which I think it will be amazing for any Christians who lost their child.
When you were in that growth time, how did other people around you respond?
People responded different way. Some of them, they thought, I am a little bit crazy to become a believer because our son died. Some others just waited, if it's just something short term or if it will be for the whole life. Some people told me, you were baptized as a baby boy, as a Catholic, so why would you like to be baptized again? And of course, some people spoke about us not nice things, because if people don't understand something, it's very easy to judge the people. Yeah.
Shortly after your baptism, this terrible loss, this time of great personal discovery, some colleagues proved not to be so loyal.
1 year after losing our little Max, three of my closest colleagues made an agreement together and stole my company.
Stole the company?
Yes. 1 year after losing Max, we didn't have any baby, and I hadn't even the company. Three people tried to hire some shooter from Russia to kill me.
Really?
It was the second step after they weren't succeed to steal my company. I prayed to the Lord. Jesus gave me strength to forgive them.
Okay.
Even though if they didn't be interested in, it was also very helpful to me personally, because I didn't feel any hate in my heart. After 3 months, I've got a company back. They've got a little bit more shares.
More equity.
Yes. I was grateful to God at the end, because the company was just before big deals. Thanks to God, thanks to these people, what they did, I could hire a new team of people. I did it with my Lord, because I prayed to be able to get in our company the right people, professionally and morally.
If Jesus wasn't in Radim's life, I don't think that his business would have grown, because everything was brought down with these horrible experiences.
With a majority of the shares of stock now in the hands of his former friends, who had wrested control of his company from him, Radim began to rebuild his organization, this time with employees whose integrity he knew he could rely on. Starting with a small group of trusted colleagues, Radim positioned his company to take advantage of the boom in real estate development that hit Eastern Europe in the first 5 years of the 21st century. Within a short while, what had been his minority share of his company had become multiples of what he once controlled, as he focused on personal and business integrity.
Job says, even though he takes my life, I will trust him.
Yes.
Is that something you found that you could begin to say?
I don't want to compare myself with such a great person like Job. Day by day, my trust in God was improving and improving. I dedicated to him everything, including my business. There was one thing we didn't dedicate to God's hands completely, and it was our desire to have another baby. More than 2 years after losing little Max, we understood it is necessary to dedicate this, for us, the most important life issue, completely to the hands of God. We were prepared to accept the will of God, even though if we won't have any other baby in our life.
Mm.
But when we did it, after 3 months, my wife was pregnant again. It was one of the nicest experiences with God in my life.
Coming a sort of full circle. And I believe he carries your name.
Yes, because Max was the first son, and we spoke with my wife even before Max was born. If we would have one day another son, he would be Radim Jr.
I can imagine every day when you see Radim Jr., some part of you thinks of him as God's gift at a time of real loss in your life.
Yes. I remember we came back from the hospital and laid him to the baby crib, kneeled down and dedicated him back to God's hands. And it was one of the greatest moments in my life. 2 years later, I had a serious car accident. God miraculously saved my life. I was the only person who was involved in the accident. I was seriously injured on my head, but God saved my life and he completely healed me. 1 year later, I've got to know that there is some relationship between my wife and some other man. So it was a very painful situation. 2007, we divorced. God gives to anybody who wants forgiveness. I needed a lot of forgiveness. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9. God wants every single person repent.
Yes.
To be in the God's kingdom. We should do the same. Shortly after, the boyfriend of my wife contacted me and asked for forgiveness. So we met. I told to him who I am, if God forgave me, not to forgive you. It was one of the nicest experiences with God. They were rebaptized, both of them.
Really?
They married, and the great experience is what we as a people do mistakenly, God can repair it. During my destroying personal life, I couldn't imagine I would be accepted that my only son that time, Radim Jr., would be raised by him.
Yes.
But after some time, I understood my son likes him. So it means he can't be such a bad person.
There we go.
And today I am really grateful to God he could repair what we destroyed.
Radim lived a very different lifestyle than how he's living now. He used to party a lot. And the moment he changed his lifestyle, greatly impacted his business world in a positive way.
As your business career began to take off, you grew more successful, were able to make more investments, you started investing in your family, in your home, even in your community.
When I accepted Jesus as my savior, I realized God is the real owner of everything what I have in my life. So I made some contract in my heart with God, how to use money which are available for my business and for my private life and of course for my ministry.
The changes that were going on in Radim's inner life began to have a greater and greater impact on the way he conducted his business, the way he structured real estate deals, the manner in which he recruited and supported employees, and the way he committed himself to bringing wholeness to everyone in his personal and business circles.
Some individuals will focus on the material things, the beautiful cars, a lovely home, and the other things you've done, the investments in people and places that don't live in a spot like this. Why does it bring you happiness to invest in building churches or starting schools? What makes that important to you?
When I realized that Jesus forgave me all my sins, it brought to my heart real peace and real happiness. Based on that, I started to look at the life completely different way, from different perspective.
The moment Radim changed his life and he believed and converted to God, his investment changed. He started investing more into family and more into advertised type of work.
In 2002, I established just private account Maranatha,
yes.
Lord is coming. When we made some profit, I put always some part of money for this account. And we started to support all the ministry project. When I promised to put some money for God's work, I always did what I promised. We all know when Jesus will come back, our materials, material things, our houses, our money, it wouldn't be something what we could take with us to heaven. So that's why I pray to God to give me wisdom and show me when it will be the time to use all the material things for sharing the gospel.
Now that Radim was busy operating a business empire, would he ever find a partner with whom to share his life?
I first met Radim in the Brumunka Fitness Center. That's where we first met, and that's where our relationship started.
You were on the treadmill one day and got to talking. What happened?
What happened?
To be honest, I saw her there.
Ah.
I sent some text message, then we've met on the lunch. But it was still quite a long way to start to date.
She soon accepted Christ as her personal savior and decided to be baptized. Radim and Barbara rejoiced at the birth of their first son, Samuel. And they were excited to bring him back home. But then... the second son, Benjamin, wasn't far behind, and they were also excited to bring Benjamin home. But then... Radim and Barbara brought home their third and last son, Timothy. Now with Radim Jr. and three new boys, the family was complete.
Now, three sons.
Yes.
And a house full of joy and laughter and play.
I think to invest your time and spend your time with kids, this is really important, because without that, how you could raise your kids for God? It is necessary to be with them, to talk with them, to play with them, but yes, also to tell them about Jesus.
My personal feeling is that he's a very polite man. He is always greeting the people who are familiar with him. So I think he's very nice person.
I think the best word is goal-oriented.
Trustworthiness.
Goal in the heaven,
yes.
Goal in the business.
I hope we will still to work together with him, UniCredit Bank and Pastor Invest Group.
BB Centrum, which Radim had been building since 1996, hosts the Eastern European headquarters of many Czech and international companies, including Microsoft, Hewlett-Packard, and UniCredit Bank.
It is a project for my whole professional life. I believe God put in our hearts some sense of beauty. God is unique and only one, but I believe we were created his image, so we can do also something to be nice for people. We understand that people are working for corporations sometimes one third of their lives, including sleeping time. And we think it's very important to prepare for them nice working environment.
I'm looking at all kinds of retail operations here in the lower level of the BB Centrum. How did these come to be, and who are some of the clients?
Retail units are very important for the whole business park, because it brings some additional value, and people who spend in their work for corporation one third of their life, they have some services directly here, which is good for them because they can save the time.
How many people are employed in what we can see around us?
Working environment here is now for 15,000 people. Let's say the final stage of BB Centrum could be easily over 20,000 people working here.
Where I come from, that's a mid-sized city.
In Czech Republic, believe me, it's even more. And this is one of the beautiful stores here, which is the jewelry and watch store. The owners came to the BB Centrum 9 years ago. They started to visit our vegetarian restaurant. They put their children to the Christian kindergarten and elementary school Elijah. The man was baptized 4 or 5 years ago. And this couple with their kids, they are coming every Sabbath to the church.
I'm very happy here and I'm very satisfied. I like the access to the owners as employees. We're doing very beautiful work, maybe some of the best in the country.
Krásny den. Naschledanou.
If I lived or worked at BB Centrum, I could do a lot of my life within a few hundred meters of here, if I wanted to. My children might be able to attend the school if I could get in line fast enough.
And this is the school Elijah.
So this would be a typical classroom?
Yes.
Okay. Smart boards in all the rooms?
Yes, in all of them. The most important is to educate young adults as a moral human being with a relationship with God. That's our focus. It was the first grade in the last school year.
I'm having to learn all kinds of new sounds and inflections. Everywhere I've gone in your world, I have seen children. I see activities for children. I see playgrounds for children. I see train yards for children. I've wondered sometimes if the story of little Max is behind a lot of that.
Definitely some way, yes. Because before I understood Bible, my ideas was to name everything according my little Max. This is just the office for the teachers. Okay.
As Radim walked me around the school campus, a public school that he had bought and completely refurbished, I saw again a commitment to children.
In terms of possible, I'd like to build for our children the nicest home I am able to build. Now we can visit the school pavilion. Mini athletic stadium. You have 100 meters run.
Thinking, and then
you have 150 meters circle. You have long jump, high jump, badminton, floorball, and outdoor exercise. We have excellent teacher for physical education. Right. So this is the new canteen.
Wow.
Yeah, over 90% kids are using meals here. It's very good for the school and for the kids. Yeah. Every summer something in our property for people from the church or from the school of our children. The podium is at the corner where's the school. We can build if you want.
Shall we? Okay, we'll do this. I'll see if I can get on it.
We are very balanced. Yeah, and we can do this.
Wow. I told you he liked to play. Yeah.
Okay.
I won't.
Dobrý den. Můžeme tady nahlídnout? We can get 18 kids per first grade.
Okay.
And this year we had over 50. Ilonka came here for our public meetings in 2014. She accepted Jesus. She started to study the Bible. She was baptized. She is the leading teacher Elijah School in the kindergarten.
Yes, of course. Okay.
Ahoj, ahoj.
There is a fitness center where I could stay physically healthy. I could eat at any number of restaurants, including vegetarian restaurant that you operate. I could even drop my dry cleaning off at retail stores. I could do my shopping here. I could do my banking.
Because the offices are key for this location. We would like to add something which creates nice atmosphere. This is the largest building in BB Centrum, building Delta.
Okay.
The shape, it's normal one. But what is quite unusual is the surrounding of the building.
If you asked me where I was right now, I would say I was in the back of your house or the backyard or perhaps on the edge of a field. But actually, we're up how many stories in the air?
We are on the level number 9.
In a roof terrace on one of the buildings you have built here in BB Centrum. Why invest in greenery and plants and, well, fresh air?
It is working environment for the people. If they have something like this, especially using during the lunchtime or during some breaks, they have something what is, we call it, added value. And if the corporation has satisfactory employees, it's much more reason to stay in the building for longer times. Especially in this building, we have Hewlett-Packard and Microsoft as a anchor tenants, and they are a long time in BB Center. There is the children playground. This is the telecommunication company O2. It was a gift of God. we would say the deal with them. Right. It was one of the two buildings sold in 2007 when I promised to God I will pay double tithe from this profit. And God doubled our profit. Well, it was amazing experience.
The windows of heaven opened.
Yeah.
I watch people walk through these sidewalks and streets, and I will tell you, they look different than many of the places I go in other industrial parks around the world. Do you think that has something to do with what you've created as a campus here?
I believe if environment is really nice, it brings some joy for people, and I believe they can maybe smile a little bit more than normally.
Radim shared how, in his goal to bring honor to God, he has made a commitment to place a visible passage of scripture on each one of the buildings the Lord has blessed him to construct.
If you have hot days, this is the cheapest water attraction for kids in Prague, because it's for free, and kids are screaming here and running into the water. And during the lunchtime, this is very lively area. This is the client center for the Microsoft here. Okay. It was about 1,000 square meters a retail unit, which is not easy for which purpose to use. It was the ideal space here. And I'll show you the main room here. God put things so beautiful way together. It was amazing. 100,000 square meters in retail in office building, it's really not easy. This is the main hall. There is the pool for baptism.
You can
move
right
it
there
out. And if you saw the picture of baptism of my son, it was here. This is the mothers and kids room, and we have some few classrooms. This is just small one. My first public meetings were just here in back.
In the back.
When we prayed, God will send us 15 people.
Right.
And it exactly happened.
What age is the church?
2009, so 10 years old building.
You're putting value into their lives, but they aren't making any immediate promises or pledges to you about what they're going to believe or do, and you're okay with that.
I would be so happy if any of them would become a Seventh-day Adventist or would become a Christian. But of course, God doesn't push us to follow him or to love him. And the same, I think, he's expecting from us. The most important for any single person is not to lose eternal life. This is the most important topic. But I have to respect all people have free choice. So this is the showroom. So this room is for presentation. It's completely new. It's from this year. And I just can show you something from the history. Now you can see how was the place 25 years ago. This is the main road on the left side. You can see the two panelaks, which we demolished already.
If ever there was a project that truly deserved the title Center of Influence, Radim Pasur's BB Centrum is certainly it. Here you taste a bit of the life you were intended to live, even in the middle of a big city. Here you see values lived out that aren't usually associated with the brutal pace of corporate culture.
We have some U.S. corporations here.
What was the use of this area out here before?
It was as a construction yard.
Construction yard, okay.
Yeah. We believe Christ will come very soon.
Yes.
But we like to do a job which can influence some part of our city.
You haven't just influenced a part of the city, you've rebuilt a city within the city, have you not?
Yes, it is one of the name of BB Centrum project. It is some way small city in the city. This is the shuttle buses, yeah?
Oh, yes. About 12,000 people work here. So there's a free shuttle bus system between here and the metro center.
This is the cars.
The Bugatti.
And this public transportation for electromobiles, recharge stations. You can see also the bus stop here. It is shuttle bus. Anybody can use it for free. This is something what helps the city itself, because it is city of short distance. And it means it's efficient. And sometimes during whole week, my wife doesn't need a car because everything is here. It's great. I think it's added value for life. We are quite small company. We have less than 70 people in our main business. In Czech Republic, every year we have first, second or third place. There was always 10 most admirable companies in the Czech Republic, and I would never guess we will be among them. But some years ago we were number 9, then number 8, then number 6, and this year we were number 3.
Which really?
I couldn't believe that, yeah.
To be honest, this town has developed and has become more modern.
You've improved the place where you live so that other people have improvements in the places where they live and work too. If you didn't live here yourself, do you think you would respond differently as a businessman in this place?
It's easily possible, because if you live here, you can experience the day-to-day life here.
In addition to the development pieces, what else has changed about the town in the years you've been here?
The most changes you can see here, which is the park, Conflict of Ages, and in the central part of the village.
Okay.
Where is new city hall, new mini market, new church building, and children traffic playground.
I love that place.
When we choose this place as our home, we would like to do not only a nice home for us, but we would like also to build something nice for the whole village.
Here in the center of town is where quite a bit of the help you've provided has shows up here. There are also other buildings, I believe.
Yes, we built also two families houses. One is for the property manager family, and the second one is for the biblical worker.
You sponsor a Bible worker here?
Yes.
This is the model train museum?
Exactly.
How did you get interested in trains?
Firstly, it was my father who promised me when I was a boy, he will build it one day. My father died in 2003, and we built this in 2011.
It seems like a great gift to a tiny village that could not have afforded many of these things.
For such a small villages, it's really very limited. Of course, I am always very glad when I can get some feedback and I can see some gratefulness of people. Because it is something what is missing from current society. Because Jesus changed my heart, the desire of me as a Christian is to build nice home for our kids, but also to do something for kids of others.
And I understand these ponds with the bubblers are also part of what you've created?
Yes, because it's quite nice area. There is some small artist work, which is the something connected with flood and Noah Ark. We try to build a nice environment in this village continuously, and I believe people like it.
Whenever I come to a town, I always notice the odd little things, like a piece of sculpture in a town of 400 people. Who does that? And a piece of sculpture that isn't just aesthetic decoration, it's a biblical story. It's a story about Noah and his wife and three sons and their wives. We're a long way from an ocean here, but according to the biblical record, this entire planet was once covered with water, and only eight people, these eight, escaped. Why was that?
Because a man followed God's word to build an ark of safety. But that ark wasn't for his family alone. The invitation was for everyone who was willing to join Noah on that ark. Here in Stetkovice and at BB Centrum in the business park, Redeem has built an ark of sorts. An ark with the invitation for anyone who is willing. Willing to accept the Savior and join him and his family for a day that is yet to come, but will come. When all of this will come to an end.
I've seen video footage of you building churches and running wheelbarrows around, and you look incredibly happy. Someone in your position could hire other people to do that for you, and yet you've chosen to get personally involved in projects to build and help people and start schools and churches. Why is that?
What we got for free from God, we would like to give free to others. God is so generous to us, and we should be changed to picture of God, to image of God. So we should be generous too, of course. If we have possibilities, we should be generous.
I met and talked with many people in Redeem's world, but Richard, an American who currently works for Redeem, his story really grabbed me.
Back in 2010, we went with Redeem to Tanzania. He went out there with a group of about 10 people, and they wanted to do like an evangelistic series out there in Tanzania. My dad asked Redeem if I could come with him. And at the time, they already knew that there were some issues with me. So I got a little bit into the opiates at that time. I was doing them every day. And there was times when I would nod off here and there. I kept it on the low. I didn't want people knowing what it is that I was doing, including my dad and my family. But they knew something was up, something was wrong. And my dad knew, and he asked Redeem and was like, look, Rick is going through some struggles right now. Can he come with us? Here's a man that could afford to take 10 other people from high professionals to go with him. But for him to decide and say, because my dad told him I'm struggling, and he said, look, this could be a life-changing situation for him. So let's bring him. And when he said that and he took me on, and to be honest, I kind of didn't really want to go because I knew that there was going to be no drugs there, but something spoke to my heart and said, look, you should go. And that's where I really got close to the Adventist family. What really changed my heart, I would say the most, is observing someone who claims to be a Christian, if he really is a Christian, if he's really living what it is that Jesus told us to live. After I got back, and I ended up going to rehab here in the Czech Republic, and I said, Lord, if you are up there, please, help me out. I mean, I felt like a little child. I was like, help me out. I promise I will go the right way. I will do whatever, but just help me out of this situation. Fell asleep, woke up the next morning, and I felt unexpectedly good. The next day I felt good. The next day I felt even better. The next day, and no withdrawal at all. So to me, that was a miracle right there. And I knew from that day on that what I promised to God has got to be something that I'm definitely keeping, because he got me out of a situation that I thought was not going to happen. I realized I need to go in the opposite direction and keep going in the opposite direction, not just get off and stop and then live that same type of lifestyle, the same mentality. I knew I had to go away from it, so I figured Jesus, him being just the perfect example, perfect man, sinless, I figured, well, why not try to go that way? I mean, it made sense to me right there and then. I just felt it in my heart, and that's the decision that I made. When I came out of the rehab after the 3 months, I felt amazingly good. I told Redeem what happened in the rehab, and Redeem responded, hallelujah.
Really?
Yeah.
In front of a crowd?
In front of a whole crowd, yeah.
When we started to build our home here, we bought also the agriculture field here. And I thought what we will do with this. And my idea was to build some park, nice park, but just to build park would be not good enough. So I asked God about some idea.
The park here that we're going by, you helped create these 12 sets of tablets that tell the story of the great controversy. In many ways, that's the key Adventist story, isn't it?
That's true. It came to my mind, the idea to build park Conflict of Ages. And I decided to build 12 stops, where is written the whole story between good and evil, between Jesus and devil.
There are 12 of these around this 40-hectare park. They were written by Redeem Pasur personally.
a summary of the story of God's plan for saving human beings from themselves. This particular one tells the story of the first rebellion against God's plan. Satan in heaven, Lucifer, known as he was then, becomes prideful in his heart and rebels against God's plan and creates anger and frustration and chaos, and ultimately brought that to our first human parents. Ever since then, we've all been looking for some signs that pointed in some different directions. Signs of hope and healing to overcome the brokenness that came into our universe because of one fallen angel and millions of people who have followed him with their lives. Tonight, just behind me, Radim Passer is telling people about how healing happens from rebellion like this, how God has a plan to restore human beings and ultimately win them back to himself because they place their trust in Jesus Christ as their Savior. You actually go out and speak and tell your story and preach.
My life story, as you said at the beginning, was nice thing and also some tragedies. And that's why I've got a lot of invitations after my conversion to share my life story. It was on ASI meeting here in Europe, and I've got even invitations from some different denominations and, of course, from many Adventist churches. Preaching our Christian message, Three Angels message, is the nicest time in the year, because we can testify, we can see how God is changing people in front of our lives. This is the most important what we can do as a Christians, to share with others our faith and our hope, which we have in Jesus.
The Apostle Paul once wrote, "I have become all things to all people, so that by all possible means I might save some." Sometimes that means preaching, and so Radim preaches.
What's the most satisfying thing when you look out here from your corner office?
I like the job which we are doing. It's a job which is visible, and it is something what can stay for generations. I am grateful to God for everything we could build so far, on the business side or even on the private side. But of course, as a Christian, I know we can't take nothing with us to heaven. The only what we can take with us is our character, changed by God's grace. The one single person saved by eternity, it's much more valuable than all treasures on this earth. I like my work, it is my hobby. I consider my work also as a part of my mission in the God's work. But at the end, the only important will be how many persons will be saved for eternity.
When Radim goes to church, he gives his whole heart to the word and to the church.
I admire Radim's passion. When he sets out to do something, he does it fully. He goes well beyond to get something done. Not every religion in this country is lucky to have such a man like Mr. Passer to sponsor so much in their town.
The greatest legacy, which I would be the most happiest man, would be if people will understand it was done because Jesus changed his life.
If you could wish one thing for all the people we're looking down on from the top of BB Central, what's the one thing you want for all of them?
I can't say anything else than as many as possible of them to be in the kingdom of God. That's the simplest answer.
It's the best one too. Thank you.
Thank you.